recording. Ready? Yep, I'm good.
Wind now 200 to 10.
I think this is the second time I've ever ridden in the back seat.
I've never ridden in the back seat. I rode in George's one day. I don't think he gave us a turnout, did he?
No, he didn't. You wanna ask him.
Rad 99, verify you wanted northbound?
Roger, Rad 99, please get a left turnout.
And then left turn was approved and frequency change approved, I'll see ya.
Thanks, we'll see ya.
Yeah, I didn't hear that.
Wind 1908.
We're still climbing pretty good. Full fuel and two big guys.
Yeah.
Man, it is filthy.
Where's your, we're about, 1,100 feet a minute?
Yep, 1,200, yeah.
1,200, yeah.
About 1,200 back here, anyway. Go to 5,500.
Okay.
And we'll head out towards the lake. And you go ahead and start leaning the engine too. About 20 gallons an hour is about right for what we got going. Well, probably less than that actually if you pull the fire back too. So about, probably about 16 gallons an hour.
Says 2-2 whiskey, ready.
Whatever gives you about 1350 on your EGTs.
Go to 12275.
Yeah, that's fine.
Northwest Texas, 10.126 is 1 north of New Anthem, leaving 3000. six whiskey-whiskeys over the B-line just north of Sycamore Creek at 5,600 headed towards Bartlett Lake, northeast.
Does it fly about like yours?
Yeah, it's pretty light on the controls compared to mine.
Really?
Yeah.
Squared is fine.
Okay.
24 squared, and you're probably about 15 gallons an hour for your.
Yeah, right now I'm 16.7, and we're at 1360 on the number three.
That's perfect.
My headset's a lot better now that I got that damn. I got the glasses off. Your thing.
Yeah, it's too, the Oregon Aero, somehow it makes it looser.
It feels a lot looser.
I mean, it's great if you're going to spend 8 hours in the airplane, but not ideal. The traffic at our low at 9 o'clock, no factor.
Got it.
And you got TCAS up there too, so.
Somewhere.
He'll give you a voice call if something gets close to you.
Okay. Is that from the 330?
No, it's an active Ryan TCAD device.
Oh.
It's actually going out and interrogating.
So you're not using CIS on the 330?
No. The thing is, it's only going to see into the mode S.
Right.
It's not going to see mode C. Saved my butt a few times already.
I thought it would show you both too, just wouldn't show you direction, it shows you altitude.
It can't interrogate mode C. If you are in a, if you're in radar coverage, then you might get it. I think that's, if I remember right, that's the way it works.
So, I got no fall, huh?
Oh, no you do. See the triangle at the top of your PFD there, your electronic display?
Huh?
See a little triangle there?
Huh?
Push on your left rudder. See the bottom of the it's like a boat in a sail.
Yeah.
That's the way we teach corporate pilots. Put the boat under the sail.
Okay.
Traffic at our 11 o'clock low. No factor.
Whiskey is 2 to the east of Bartlett Lake and Dam at 6,000 feet westbound.
Northwest Fox area. Mentor Red 99 will be doing practice maneuvers, block altitude, 4,000, 6,000 above Lake Pleasant. Alright.
Okay. So what we'll do here is go ahead and give me 2,400 RPM. Give me a cardinal heading of about west.
Yeah, at 2,800 doing ground 11 direction, northwest.
Northeast practice area, transfer 924, 5 mile west to Pinnacle Peak.
Alright, so give me a left turn, 180 degrees, level turn, at least 60 degrees of bank and 2 G's.
60 degrees?
Yeah, at least. That's a minimum. There's 60. making turns as well. Okay. Looks pretty good. Now we're going to go ahead and start easing the power off. Just maintain altitude and start the power off. We'll do a power off stall straight ahead just to get started. Do here is you're going to maintain the stall, so you're going to keep the stick full aft, and I want you to keep the wings level using just the rudders.
Okay. Bring the manifold back to...
Just go ahead and all the way down to idle. It's fine. You got a mute button there. There you go. There's a mute button there. On that. There you go.
Cool now. West of Pinnacle Peak, so low flat.
Go ahead and go all the way down. All the way back. Carry the stick. Keep the stick in your lap. In your lap. Don't use the ailerons. Just use the rudders. So, don't use the ailerons.
Oh!
Alright. I have the controls.
Okay.
Alright, I'm gonna go idle. We're just gonna hold it up here. There's a stall. See the stick's aft? I'm not moving the stick left and right. I'm only using the rudders. Now I have a little off the brake pressure, recover, flies right out. And we lost just about 1,000 feet doing that, so we'll climb back up here. But you were trying to use the ailerons?
I was.
And when you do that,
you're worse.
That's what's happening, because you're changing the angle of attack on the, you have the flight controls? Because what you're doing is, when you deflect that aileron, you are actually changing the angle of attack. And so you're actually aggravating it and making it worse. So you're giving, what you're doing is setting yourself up for a spin, because as soon as you deflect that stick, you've increased the angle of attack on one wing and decreased on the other, which makes it want to roll over that much harder.
I wasn't expecting
But you can see, it's controllable with just the rudders, but you got to be full deflection and kind of be Johnny on the spot.
Right.
It's not a 172. It's a much more critical airfoil. Alright, once you get to 5,500, go ahead and give me a right turn back to the east, and we'll do one more of those. And all I'm trying to get you to do here is to get relaxed in that regime of the wing's not flying, but you can still control it because you got plenty of slipstream over the rudder. Since you're an RC guy, you probably are aware, you know, some RC airplanes, they only have three channels.
Right.
They got throttle, elevator, and rudder. So the most important flight control of this airplane is your rudder. Because the nose position we can change with power, and even if your elevator is frozen, you can fly the airplane using just the power. We practice that, actually. So the most important thing, the biggest thing that you don't want to lose is your rudder. If you got your rudder, you can fly the airplane. Alright, so let's go ahead and start reducing the power back. And when you get to idle, just go ahead and silence that horn there. Go ahead and go all the way to idle. Quick. Silence the horn. It may not sound since that low back. It's okay. Let's listen to it. Alright. Just keep the back pressure in. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Don't add power. Don't add power. That's what makes it worse. Keep adding the back pressure. Just your rudders. Full back stick, full aft. Just the rudders.
500 at the
see what you're doing with the stick?
Huh? Alright, do it again.
more time from
here? Yeah, just jet from here.
Inventory is coming.
All the way to idle. I have your power now.
Okay.
I have the power. Back stick, back stick, back stick. Just nice and easy. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Keep feeding it in. Lock it in the center. Lock the stick in the center. Only use the rudders. Only the rudders. Now release the back pressure, and we're flying again, yeah?
Not it.
No? Too much. There you go. Now you're flying again. Now, ease the nose up. Hold it there. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Hold it. Just keep halting. Center stick. Full aft. Use your rudders. Don't use your stick. There you go. Now, ease off the back pressure. Alright, now we're going to fly out. We're darn good. Alright, you got the power now. Cheers. But you see what you're doing there, right?
I do. I understand you understand more importantly how the aileron is changing the angle of the tank that's making it worse.
Yeah. You're getting into advanced level aerodynamics now. And that's the key though, you know, these training airplanes like 172s and Pipers and everything, you can sit there and keep the yoke all the way back, you'll just buck a little bit, and you can roll in and roll out, and it teaches bad habits. Because in a higher performance airplane like a Bonanza, because we have the same airfoil basically as a Bonanza in this airplane. So in a Bonanza, then they go to hop in a Bonanza, they get into a stall, and they try to raise the wing with the yoke, and that all they do is end up in a spin. But you can see how snappy it is.
Very, very snappy.
When you get a break, in other words, when the wing breaks, it's done flying completely. There's no hint of, I'm here, but I'm kind of here.
There's no buffet, it's just break.
There's actually, and I'll show you this too, there's actually quite a bit of buffet. It's just that you don't notice it. So like right now, what we'll do is, why don't you go ahead and roll it in a little bit tighter, and just start pulling. A little tighter pull. A little more pull. And as soon as you feel that buffet, I want you to relax the back pressure. Feel that buffet? See how easy it is? It's such a docile airplane if you respect that buffet. Pull the buffet again. And you get the buffet relaxed back pressure. Just relax back pressure. And you see what you started to do there? You wanted to get that yoke, that stick in. Buffet, and as soon as you get to the buffet, just relax it. Feel the buffet coming? Relax it, and it flies out. Yep. You can even keep the nose up, and it'll still just, it'll keep climbing. It'll give me another left turn, climbing. Just keep it coming nice and easy, not a hard pull. And as soon as you get that buffet, just relax a little bit. Don't lower the nose, just relax the back pressure. Okay, lower it. There you go. See? Flies right out. As soon as you feel that, you know where you're at.
Know what's coming next.
Okay, so now we're going to go ahead and start bringing the power back. We'll stay down low airspeed here. And we're going to do a one-turn spin to the left. Okay?
You're going to do it, or?
So, I have the flight controls.
Hey.
I want you to stay on the controls. I want you to follow me through.
Got it.
This is going to be a one-turn to the left, okay?
Got it.
So you got a reference point out there. Look left, look right, get some reference points there. The power's all the way off. And we're gonna note the altitude when we start. I'll call it out for you. I'm at 5,800, 35,800. Full left rudder, full aft stick. There's a half, quarter, a four. off my heading just a little bit.
Only about 20 degrees.
So, that was, I started my recovery just a little bit early, so about a quarter turn is what it takes in the first turn. And you notice we went down to 4,800 feet, so we lost 1,000 feet for a one turn spin.
Well, I want you to do one more, because
Okay.
I was looking at the turn of bank here, and...
Okay. So, you're on the controls though, right? You can feel everything?
My hands on them.
Okay, and your feet on the rudders?
Because
the rudders are the most important part of this maneuver. The elevator is important too, but the rudders are really important. Alright, so we have plenty of altitude, we're going to start easing that power back. Easing it off.
There's a lovely horn. And then left rudder, flap stick. There's a half. There's a quarter. Neutralize. Recover from the dive. That's all there is to it.
Pretty easy, yeah?
It is for you.
You feel okay?
Yeah. Oh yeah, I'm fine. I'm just looking at the rudder. So you basically got up, threw in full left rudder.
Yep, full left stick, full left rudder, and you hold that until you want to recover. And then it's full opposite rudder, and not forward stick, just relax the back pressure.
Okay.
Because if you go forward stick, you're going to shove us into the canopy, and the oil's going to go everywhere. You know what I mean?
Right.
Okay. So we're going to come around here to the left. You have the flight controls. Come around to the south. And we'll keep the climb going. Now what we're going to do, this time you have the flight controls, you're flying the airplane, I'm going to follow you through, okay?
Okay.
So if you feel any pressure, that'll be me, and I'll tell you what I'm doing as I'm doing it, okay?
Got it.
But you are flying, okay?
Okay.
Now you notice we didn't pull a lot of G's, it wasn't really violent.
Oh.
It's just kind of, you know, it's the parts and that's just it. Okay, so start easing the power back. Keep this nose attitude. The steeper the nose attitude, the more violent the entry. Traffic up our left, no factor. So just keep easing that power off, keep that nose up. And you want to stay coordinated. Stay coordinated.
All the way to idle now. Keep that nose up. 5,800 feet. Keep that nose up.
Alright, full left rudder, full left stick. Keep it coming. Right rudder, and relax the back pressure. That was all you. Easy on the pull.
There you go.
Now go ahead and get the nose up, and get the power in, because we want to use our energy to get our altitude back. So we just lost the altitude, but now we got airspeed, so we're going to trade that. So full power. All the way to stop. In fact, I'm going to sneak your RPM up here a little bit to 2500.
Okay.
That's me doing that. Alright, I'm showing 2500 back here. Is that what you got back there?
2520.
Yep, 2510. Okay, that's close enough. Okay, now we're going to keep the climb going. We're going to go back up to 5800. And that was all you.
Okay.
So, did that make sense?
Absolutely.
Now, the one thing that I will say with that, you didn't quite have, got traffic to our left, I'm not sure what he's up to.
Up our left?
Yeah, I got him, he's at my 7 o'clock now, he's above us. Go ahead and give me a turn to the left.
Over New River, 6,500, eastbound, north practice.
He's at our 9 o'clock high, you got him?
Oh yeah.
Radio for just a second. Northwest practice area, RAT 99 is a T-34, maneuvering under below 6,000 feet, aerobatics, north end of the lake for northwest practice area. Traffic area of Lake Pleasant, please advise.
Northwest practice area, trans flight 288, we're 6,500 to 7,000 north end of Lake Pleasant maneuvering.
Okay, Mentor, we got the trans flight aircraft in sight. As long as you stay above 6, we should be good.
Roger, we'll stay at 7 then. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. So ease the power off.
And Northwest practice area, trans flight 299 is approaching the north end of Lake Pleasant. We're at
5,700 right now, heading eastbound toward Wickenburg, correction, westbound toward Wickenburg.
Russian 9 is over the north end of the lake at 5,900, southbound, looking for that traffic. Alright, keep it coming, hold it up, hold it up, hold it up.
To the west of Rio Verde, 4,300.
Alright, bury the stick all the way. Full left rudder. Keep the stick buried in center. Right rudder. Ease the stick. Ease it. There you go. There you go. Now you see what happened there. You're reluctant to ease the back pressure. Is the only thing that's going to get guys out of stalls and spins is to release the back pressure, and it's the last thing they want to do because they want to get away from the ground. And so there's that natural reaction to pull back harder. The more the nose buries, the harder they want to pull. You know what I mean?
Got it.
Doing okay?
Yep, fine.
Alright, man. You're doing really well. That was all you. I wasn't on the controls at all, so...
Okay.
It's a confidence thing, you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
And it's not only a confidence thing, it's also a matter of spending time doing it, and the more you do it, the more it becomes second nature.
Absolutely.
But so this is a good heading, you can hold this, and 5,500, that's plenty. Go ahead and just start easing the power off.
5,700 to be beat. We have that mentor. We're back on your right-hand side behind you. Same altitude.
Okay, we got you in sight. We're doing spins here at or below 6, so if you can maintain visual separation, I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
Thanks. Alright, keep the nose up. 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 Bury the stick, hold up rudder. Right rudder. Ease the nose. Boom! Right there. Perfect. Easy on the pull. That was really good. You see how you get into the accelerated stall there on the second part? You're too anxious to get the nose up. It'll fly itself out.
I'm gonna try it one more time and really do.
Okay, perfect. But you're within a quarter turn of your exit there.
Northwest, 10 foot 14.
For a full spin, for a full turn?
Yep. You did a turn and a quarter instead of one turn. Well, not bad, because originally we were pointing the other direction, right?
Okay, so we're going at 160 right now.
Yeah, don't worry about that. Everything's outside. Aerobatic pilots don't have instruments. The only thing you need to know about is your altitude. Look left, look right, look left, look right. Know where you are, get reference points. Because that's what's going to tell you where you're going to be when you recover. Okay?
Right.
Okay, ease the power on. Plenty of altitude. Keep pulling it back, keep pulling it back, keep pulling it back. Keep the nose coming. A little more back pressure, a little more back pressure, a little more back pressure. Pull left rudder, pull left stick. A right rudder. You gotta go full right rudder. There you go.
I was more concerned about where I was coming out of than I was off the maneuver.
I have the controls. And you stay with me here, and I'm just going to real quickly get up back up to altitude here. We're going to do one more. The reason that you're taking a little longer to recover is because you're not getting full deflection with the opposite rudder. You're going about a half to three quarters.
Oh, I got it.
You got to go to the stop.
Got it.
If it's not at the stop, you haven't, you have, in other words, you have flight control that you aren't using.
Right.
And the last thing you want to do is be timid with the controls when you're flying, when you're trying to recover from a spin. Because you're commanding the airplane where you want it to go, and you're in charge.
Got it.
And that's the important thing that you got to remember. I'm going to give you a little more uptrim here. And that's the important thing that you got to remember is, you know, guys who don't fly acro, they're not used to going to the stops, and it's an odd feeling. But you have the flight controls. I'm off. that knows where it is, start easing the power off.
Northwest practice area, Mentor. Track 99 is maneuver tempo 6000, over the center of Lake Pleasant, Northwest practice area.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Full left, full left. Full right. Ease those. Hey, look at that. Dead on. Dead on. Way to go, man. That was beautiful. I wish I had a thing to sound some fucking horn back here. Alright, so, that went really well. You feel comfortable?
Oh, that was good.
Okay. Now, I have the flight controls. Now, this one we're going to go a little bit farther. And the only reason I'm going to do this is because I want you to see how the behavior of the spin changes as you go past one turn. So far, we've done one turn spins. It's very predictable and very easy to control, right? And the recovery technique is the same, and the recovery response just takes a little bit longer because of the inertia that you build up. You build a little bit of a coupling, a pitch and roll coupling, and you get a little bit of inertia. You get that, you know, heavy weight out there spinning around, and it takes a little bit longer to stop. But that's the one real big thing. The other thing is you're going to notice that the nose wants to hunt around. Remember how we're doing when we're doing the aggravated stalls? How it kind of was kind of this way, that way, this way, that way. It's a little bit like that in the way it goes. So we're going to start at 6,000. And you notice, too, we've never lost more than 1,000 feet for a one-turn spin.
Right.
Which is actually not that bad, right? Everybody thinks, oh my gosh, you know, one-turn spin, you really lose like 3,000 feet.
A traffic 700.
Okay.
Oh, there it is right there.
The translate battery, center Lake Pleasant, 6,700, climbing 7,000, maneuvering.
All right, in sight for Ratman 9, again, we'll save low 6, thanks.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we're going to do two, and how much are you going to lose?
We're going to do two turns, and now because the rotation rate decreases, we're only going to lose about 1,500 feet.
We're heading back to Deer Valley, northwest.
Okay.
918, just to the south of the shooting range.
Anything else different? You still planned up pretty hard, huh?
Everything else is the same. All spins are done with full deflections. So we're all the way off. I'm going to bleed my airspeed off here, and we're going to go, I'll probably get us to about 5,900, I'm guessing, is what we're going to get out of this. There's 5,900. Boom. Full left, full left. There's a half. There's one. There's a half. There's two. And see, it takes a little bit longer on that.
It does get faster, doesn't it?
Yeah. And if you hold it for like three turns, it gets more and more fast.
2 miles.
He is ahead of us, about 100 feet above us.
Okay.
Actually, he's right off the nose.
You got him?
I lost him on the radar.
Alright. Okay. You ready for some rolls?
Yes.
Okay.
Station at 382, 3 miles south of Black Mountain.
You got the flight controls.
Okay.
Go ahead and climb us back up to about 5,500 or so.
Okay.
On the rolls, the common mistakes are, guys don't get full deflection. They don't. They have dead feet, and they don't use their rudders.
Northwest Mountain, 4,500. Northwest right there.
Northwest practice area, Mentor maneuvering between 6,000 and 4,000 aerobatics over the center of the Lake Pleasant. So, the dead feet, they don't get full deflection, and when you get inverted, people have a tendency to stop, they hesitate, they freeze a little bit, they get gimbal lock in their brain, you know what I mean?
Okay.
But those are the common errors. So go ahead and lower the nose, we'll get some smash back. Go ahead and bring your boost pump on the low for these.
Okay, boost close on the low.
Alright. Got plenty of 130 knots in airspeed, that's plenty. Go ahead and raise the nose. Keep it coming, full left stick, a little bit of left rudder. Keep it all the way over. There you go. Now you see you kind of pulled there?
Yeah.
Alright, so I have the flight controls.
Okay.
And I want you to stay on the, I'm going to come around to the north here. I want you to stay on the controls with me and feel what I'm doing here. So I'm flying, you follow me through.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
So far, starting to feel a little bit.
Okay. We'll do one more roll, and we'll check how you feel, okay?
Alright.
So, I'm flying.
Alright.
You're going to follow me through.
Got it.
We're going to raise the nose, nice and easy. Full left rudder. I'll be full left aileron, a little bit left rudder. That's it. Go pull. You don't need to pull. If you pull, as you go beyond, because what we're doing is controlling our lift vector, you know what I mean?
Northwest, translate 288-7000.
So when you're inverted, if you have back pressure, what happens? The nose, you pull through, right? And that's what guys, that's what kills guys doing rolls, is they get the inverted, and they have back pressure. And like I said, when the nose, when the ground starts getting big and the nose is down, what do guys do? They pull harder. And they split us, they end up doing a split S into the ground, basically. Make sense?
It does.
You doing okay?
Yeah.
If you feel it at all, just let me know, because we'll call, we'll knock it off and head back.
Probably one more.
Okay. So you have the flight controls. Alright. So I want you to raise the nose. Nice and easy. Full left stick, a little bit of left rudder. A little bit of left rudder, not full. Alright. Just let the nose come up nice and natural. You see, the other thing that happens there is when you went full left rudder, you were actually digging the nose toward the ground.
Oh.
You know what I mean?
Okay. How about one more?
Okay, go ahead. Whenever you're ready. So bring the nose up. I'll tell you when. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Keep it coming. Neutral. Neutral. Full left rudder. Full left aileron. A little bit left rudder. And just nice and easy on the pull there. There you go. So go ahead and come around to the right to have the heading south. Doing alright?
Yeah.
Okay. Thing is, as soon as you start to feel it, the front factor goes down rapidly, so. And people forget that we still gotta fly back to the airport. Alright, so you good for one more?
Yeah.
Okay. I want you to lower the nose this time a little bit. We're gonna get a little more smash, because we're gonna make this last longer so you can see stuff, okay? So about 160 knots.
Go.
That's perfect. Now start ease the nose up, ease it 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 up. Neutral. Pull up the aileron. A little bit left rudder now. A little bit more left rudder. A little bit more left rudder. There you go. Now back to the right. Hey, how'd that feel?
That was good. That was easy.
Very nice. You see the difference? It starts out as mostly aileron and a little bit of rudder, and it ends up with a little bit more rudder, because as your airspeed decays, your ailerons become less effective. There you go. A little more left, a little more left. Perfect.
Alright. That's it.
Okay.
Watch your fly for a minute.
I had the flight controls. Nice and easy, start heading back.
Northwest practice area, we're at 99,
departing the Lake Pleasant area, heading back to Deer Valley. just move your head as little as possible.
Okay, I got it.
So you have the flight controls. And just look straight ahead, try to move your head as little as possible. And we'll head on back. You can go ahead and give me tower frequency for the comms.
Okay, you're on tower.
Alright, perfect.
So 7 whiskey contact ground.
And you have the radios, you're all good.
Number 29 and 125 right, line up in white, traffic down 1.
Whatever you want to do, we can go overhead, you can go straight in, whatever you want to do.
10-4-4-3, 125 right, continue traffic holding in position.
It hasn't changed.
Follow the pipe in midfield, down 1, number 2.
Hey, number 2, looking for the piper, 6-8-2-8.
6-8 alpha. Then turn left to right, this tag's running contact ground.
Okay, go ahead and turn left, Bravo 5, then we'll contact ground 120.8.
The ladder tower comes at 299 just over the shooting range, and inbound for full stop with Victor.
Say again, your call sign.
My call sign is 10 flight 299.
Just say 299 to Valley Tower, and right down 125, make right traffic on 125 right.
Left traffic, so runway 25 right, cancel out 299.
I got it.
299, make
right. 1 o'clock level.
Right, right,
so
it's a takeoff.
25 right,
so it's a takeoff from right traffic. Left traffic, 999. Translate 443,
125 right, cancel out, so yeah. Runway 25 right, clear for tactical, taxi out, back up 3.
Roger, Valley Tower, Rat 99, hitting range, inbound.
That was somewhat unreadable, try again.
Roger, Valley Tower, Rat 99, inbound, full stop.
Rat 99, safe position.
Just over the shooting range for Rat 99.
99, multiple inbounds from the northwest, down a right down window, make right traffic on 25 right.
Right traffic for 25 right for Rat 99.
So 68 Juliet, follow the pipeline, base ID right, number 25 right, clear to land.
Have the traffic follow, clear to land, 25 right, 68 Juliet.
Chesapeake 425, follow Cessna, pass tower right downwind.
Roger, Chesapeake 425, local traffic.
Chesapeake 9829, follow company Piper just west of I-17 on downwind entry, just west of the Happy Valley overpass.
We're looking for 529.
Valley Tower, Cessna 4022 Whiskey, push up runway 25 right at alpha level and ready for departure.
4022 Whiskey, Valley Tower, short of 125 right. Cessna 22 Whiskey, lead back, holding short, 125 right.
Holding short over 25 right, 4022 Whiskey.
Who's over canal and freeway now?
Cessna 299 over canal and freeway.
Chesapeake 299, turn right and fly directly southbound for sequencing.
Turn right and fly southbound, Chesapeake 299.
Chesapeake 299,
traffic
in sight. Chesapeake 299, roger, follow company.
299, roger. Flat 99, mile 143 is 5,200 over Posen, inbound. Actually, one touch to go, got a confirmation, Victor.
Okay, I stepped on that. Rat 99, are you approaching Canal and Freeway now?
Rat 99, Burris.
Rat 99, I need you to widen to the right and follow the pipe at 12 o'clock and a mile. Also widening out to the right for sequencing, your number 7.
Rat 99, we got traffic.
Rat 99, follow the piper.
Rat 99, follow the piper.
Trace site 29 or turn downwind now.
Turning downwind, turn downwind, turn downwind.
Turn site 299, follow company straight ahead in the wing up turn to the downwind. Hey, you guys rock, thanks for the help. Calling in mountain northeast, northwest, say again.
Turn site 423, shooting range, 4,800, touch and go, Victor.
Turn site 423 to Valley Tower, make right traffic on my 25 right.
Right traffic, 25 right, turn site 423.
Turn site 425, number 2, follow Cessna short final, I have a departure priority arrival.
Roger, turn site 425, number 2, we've got that traffic in sight.
Here's the sequence. 425 is about to be number 1 on the midfield downwind. Translate 929, number 2 behind company. Translate 299 and number 3. Route 99 is number 4. Translate 443. Follow a man shag, canal and freeway. He's following the freeway inbound and then will turn downwind. So I need you to fly upwind another mile before turning crosswind.
Fly upwind another mile. We have side translate 443.
443, follow the man chain.
I got one guy, I don't have three.
I got two.
Yeah,
two.
Yeah,
we're
going
he said we're number four.
Northwest.
Right.
6-8, do way contact ground point 8.
Oh, I got somebody on turn 8. Looks like they're weighing up turn final.
2-2 whiskey.
Okay.
2-5 right, no delay, clear for takeoff, traffic on final.
Clear for takeoff, no delay, 2-2 whiskey.
Just like 425 on 125 right, clear to land.
Go to land, 25 right, has a 45.
Just at 45, additionally caution weight turbulence, small jet arrival on the south runway.
Roger that, 45 out of that traffic.
Just at 9290, number 2, follow full stop company, number 25 right, clear, touch and go, right, close, traffic approved.
Touch and go, 25 right, traffic attack, outside 9290.
Just at 2990, number 3, follow company, number 25 right, clear to land.
Number 3, traffic in sight, will follow, clear to land, 25 right, traffic right, 2999.
We're at 99, number 4, follow the Piper, number 25 right, clear to land.
Follow the Piper for Route 99.
Like 443, follow company off your right, RB, Man Chang, runway 25 right, number 5, clear touch and go, traffic ahead, full stop.
These guys fly the longest
pieces,
alone.
Yeah.
Just like 423 is number 6, follow company off your right side.
Alright, we're number 6, looking for the traffic, translate 423.
Tower 10529, as well, 80 miles northwest, request inbound inbound touchdown, we're waiting for
the
I never, it's so hard to get used to being able to fly downwinds at 90 knots.
Just say 297 is always there, and right downwind at 125.
I get nervous below 200 knots integrated.
Everybody call 25294, 8 mile east of the valley, in Mount Football, but we I lost my grabbing.
Just a lander 24 to Valley Tower, make straight in, number 25 right.
You throw half laps out, you'll have a lower nose angle.
Just a 423, verify position for me, please.
Now, 3-way
423. Thanks, just a 423, company is at Happy Valley overpass on the downwind, follow him.
Looking for that traffic, still 10-5-4-2-3.
I don't see him.
Okay,
I think he turned 8 miles northwest, inbound, 4 stop, information uniform.
I got a guy on final. That's not him though, right?
He's turning, he's going to be wing up here in a second.
Cardinal 2819er X-ray in orbit, 5 miles northeast of the airport. Request landing with Victor.
Okay, I got him.
Valley Tower number 9. Remain outside Glass Delta airspace and standby.
I will remain clear of the space, stand by.
Just like 425, exit first taxiway, no delay.
I got 3 green.
Roger that.
Well,
I got 3 tires.
Thank you, sir.
These guys go ridiculously slow. If you get too close, you're going around.
3 follow company midfield downwind.
So look for the traffic.
Yeah, I've had to do that once.
Traffic inside, just like 423, fall.
Just say 423, follow that traffic, but I'll probably amend the sequence shortly. I've got a straight into 5th between y'all.
I need to call my day, that's close, just say 423.
Very good. Translate 297, are you over Canal and Freeway?
Yeah, come back to Nassau, I'll work on that for you.
Just say 297, follow company straight ahead, 1 mile on the 45.
7-8, decide to come back to Nassau, I'm sorry. Shoot, I lost him again.
Got translate 443, I'd like to make this a full stop.
Translate 443,
I got him. That's your one movement or two.
243, yeah, follow the Nanchang, 125 right, clear land.
Also Nanchang.
Land, behind the Nanchang, translate 443.
Translate 924, change to runway 25 left, make straight in, south runway, contact tower, 18-4.
Contact tower, 4, Vickers,
Same tanks,
alright?
Yeah, as long as you got fuel.
Work behind that traffic that you are.
You should.
Follow him, he's full stop.
We got 9.5,
yeah. That sounds about right.
Alright, number 5, clear to, Translate 423.
Translate 9029, extend up 2 miles. 2 miles, please. I've got traffic holding outside to get in before you arrive again.
Okay, we'll go up 2 miles and we'll be full stop this time. Translate 9029.
Andrew White Tower, citation 8 Civic Mike, sound of visual.
Citation 7 Victor Mike to Valley Tower, remain at or above 3,500 and continue.
We will stop at 3,500 and we'll continue. 7 Victor Mike.
through okay?
7 Vic.
Yeah, that's fine. Vic, all
right. I want you to come right over the field and make left traffic to runway 25 left.
Okay, we'll go right over the field and we'll make traffic to 25 left.
Hey, 3 green, pop 4.
Vic to Mike again. We remain at or above 3,500. The south controller will break that for you. Contact tower 118.4.
8.4, and we'll stop at 3,500. Vic to Mike.
Who's over Canal and Freeway now?
Unavailable. Left.
10-5-9-1-8, Canal and Freeway.
10-5-9-1-8, continue on downwind entry.
Continue downwind entry, 10-5-9-1-8.
Sesame 9 X-ray, continue in a right 180, and then fly base for runway 25 right.
Continue in right orbit, and then continue for a base entry to 25 right.
Sesame 9 X-ray, that's correct. Just a right turn, and then fly base.
That's for 19er X-ray, correct?
That's correct, sir. Translate 29 under contact ground 18.
Clock, same altitude.
Flat 99, contact ground 18. Thanks for your help.
Thanks, we'll see you.
All right, here we go. Translate 443 is now at
we're ready to go on to the 87 clear rolling 25 left at Cali 9.
Hold on, man.
Translate 87 really ground. Thank you for the ramp without delay.
Pleasure to be up to the 87.
Fucker 1630, follow the Seminole on the ramp and cutters 122.95.
1295, we'll go. See now.
See
ya. Alright, about ground, Route 99, Alpha 9, north side.
Route 99, about ground, taxi via Alpha or straight ahead, your choice.
Thanks, we'll see ya. Okay, landing lights off. Fuel pump off.
Well, man, you got a job.
That was a lot of fun. I just funny there at the end. I was.
Yeah, you know.
Okay, I don't wanna.
Yeah, the fun level, like I said, goes down quickly.
Oh, I still having fun, but.
Yeah.
I didn't want to.
No, that's a smart thing, man. I mean, as soon as you feel it, the problem is, guys start to feel, they're like, okay, I can do one more, and then it's too late. Kill those toggles for the camera and the recording.